top myths about diabetes is that diabetes is caused by consuming too much sugar. And the reality is that while consuming excessive sugar and a high-calorie diet can contribute to obesity and increase the risk of type 2 diabetes, diabetes is a complex condition. It's influenced by various factors, and those include genetics, lifestyle, and your overall diet. Type 1 diabetes, for example, is an autoimmune condition with no known dietary causes whatsoever. That being said, type 2 diabetes is often linked to factors like genetics, obesity, and a sedentary lifestyle. Reducing sugar intake can be helpful in managing diabetes, but it's not the sole cause of the condition. Managing diabetes typically requires a multifaceted approach that includes dietary choices, physical exercise, medication if your doctor prescribes it, and regular monitoring of your blood sugar levels. Now, it's worth mentioning that it is extremely important to consult with your healthcare professional for accurate information and guidance on diabetes and prevention management for your individual needs. Type 2 diabetes is a chronic metabolic condition that affects how your body processes glucose, which is the fancy scientific word for sugar. And that is a crucial source of energy for all of your cells in your body. Here's what happens when you have type 2 diabetes. It starts with insulin resistance. In type 2 diabetes, your body's cells become resistant to the effects of insulin. And that insulin is a hormone that's produced by the pancreas. And so insulin helps glucose enter the cells where it's used for energy. With insulin resistance, your cells don't respond effectively to that insulin. So that then causes high blood sugar levels. Due to the insulin resistance, the glucose remains in your bloodstream, leading to elevated blood sugar levels, which is also known as hyperglycemia. This can cause various symptoms, including increased thirst, frequent urination, and general body fatigue. Now, the pancreatic response, initially, the pancreas tries to compensate by producing more insulin to lower the blood sugar levels. Over time, though, the pancreas may not keep up with the increased demand for insulin. This then leads to what's known as beta cell dysfunction. In many cases, the insulin-producing beta cells in the pancreas may become less effective, or they may just stop working altogether. This further impairs the body's ability to regulate blood sugar. The long-term complications of that are pretty severe. So over time, uncontrolled type 2 diabetes can lead to serious health complications. And that includes heart disease, stroke, kidney disease, nerve damage, even vision problems and foot and ankle problems. Proper management of type 2 diabetes is crucial to reduce the risk of these complications that can go along with the diabetes. Lifestyle factors are also important, such as diet, your physical health activity, and your body weight. They all play a significant role in development and the management of your type 2 diabetes. Maintaining a healthy weight, eating balanced meals, staying physically active, and even managing your stress levels are essential components of diabetes management. Now, that being said, your doctor may also prescribe medication and insulin. In some cases, the lifestyle changes alone just aren't sufficient to manage your diabetes. So the medication and insulin therapy may be prescribed to help control your blood sugar levels that way as well. It's important to note that type 2 diabetes is a progressive condition, and its management may evolve and change over time. Early diagnosis and effective management can help control your blood sugar levels. They may reduce some of the symptoms, and they can also lower the risk of further complications. It will involve regular blood sugar monitoring, sticking to the treatment plan that your doctor prescribes, and working closely with healthcare professionals that may include a registered dietitian, just to make sure that you are successfully and effectively managing your type 2 diabetes. So I hope that was helpful. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos. Until next time, everyone, be well, and I will see you soon.